Electric circuits and the hydraulic analogy, resistor behavior. A resistor partially blocks flow. When there is flow through a resistor, there is a drop in voltage or pressure in the direction of flow. Drop in voltage for an electronic transistor, drop in pressure for a hydraulic resistor. Ohm's law says the voltage drop is equal to the current times the resistance. It's important to understand voltage drop means the difference in voltage from one end to the other. For example, if you have 10 volts here and 9 volts here, that's a drop of 1 volt. This resistor has a resistance of 1 ohm or 1 volt per amp. If there's no current flowing through it, there's no voltage drop. If 1 amp flows through it, there's 1 volt drop. If there are 2 amps flowing through, there's 2 volts drop. Let's say that this hydraulic resistor has a resistance of 100 kilopascals per liter per second. If there's no flow through the resistor, there is no pressure difference. If there's 1 liter per second flowing through, there's a 100 kilopascal drop. And if 2 liters per second are flowing through, there is a 200 kilopascal drop. Energy is converted to heat. The power is equal to the voltage drop multiplied by the current. For this resistor, if the voltage drop is 1 volt and the current is 1 amp, the power dissipated is 1 watt. For this hydraulic resistor, if the resistance is 100 kilopascals per liter per second, if the pressure drop is 100 kilopascals and the flow rate is 1 liter per second, the power dissipation is 100 watts. These are the electric and hydraulic quantities and units. Current is like the flow rate. Voltage is like pressure. Resistance in ohms, which means volts per amp, is like hydraulic kilopascals per liter per second. And power is in watts for both cases, volt amps in the electric case and kilopascal liters per second in the hydraulic case. The behavior of resistors is fairly straightforward, but the hydraulic analogy for capacitors and inductors is more challenging and more interesting.